welcome back.
We're back for another Indi and Milly video, except this time it is a series.
This is our one bite series,
where we try three different locations of the same type of food or drink and rate them to see which one we think is the best.
So how we are rating these is basically a skating judging system. So it goes from -5 all the way to +5. We are rating it on aesthetic of the actual food or drink.
Vibe. So like, is the place cute?
The atmosphere. How's the atmosphere?
Then price, if it's expensive, cheap, and taste. So what happened?
Four categories.
So today we're gonna be doing
five location.
Oh yeah.
Also location.
This is one bite latte edition. Okay, our first stop, Cha Cha Matcha. Woo!
Adorable. I love it.
They have cool cha-cha pictures everywhere, cool light-up
signs. This is
like
my spot. This is my spot.
Yeah, it's all like pink, green.
Yeah, I think it's super cute. The only thing that I don't like is how loud the music is. Yeah.
I wish the music was a little bit quieter, but
I like spots for us to sit.
Yeah, there weren't enough people.
Like, and especially if you're getting coffee, though.
Yeah.
You kind of want a spot to sit, but it was kind
of
crowded.
There's like a lot of tables, but they're all like super small for maybe like one person.
That could be one of the.
But I think it's really cute.
Then price, how much was it?
$4.75.
So
like $5.
Might actually be pretty good. Like,
yeah, for like
it's
this
pretty
design
normal, and
stuff,
it's, I think
easy.
It's like a 3. It's not super cheap, so
I give it a 3. For the look of the latte, that's a criteria.
Yeah. So it's a palm tree, and I really love
that. It's a little palm tree.
The cup is super cute, the coasters, the napkins are super cute.
So for looks,
everything,
I give it a 5.
Actually,
you know what? I'm gonna give it a +3.
We didn't put it in the speaker. I don't know if I like matcha either. It's actually not that bad. I kind of like it too.
Cause it's not too sweet.
That's pretty good.
It's pretty good.
I haven't had another matcha latte to compare it to.
It's very earthy though.
It tastes like pretty
matcha's
good.
Matcha's a very earthy flavor, but it's pretty good.
I kind of like it, and I've never really liked matcha before.
Location, I would say it's pretty.
There's a soul cycle over there.
It's in a pretty like nice area and like seems pretty safe, and it's also pretty convenient to like.
Yeah.
There's other things around it, so you can do more than just come here.
Like, yeah,
you
don't there's have to a set flat iron over there. It's not like in the middle of nowhere, because there are a lot of places like that. I kind of want to try their rainbow one, or they had a red one.
So that's Cha Cha Matcha. Stop number one. On to the next.
Next stop is the El Room Cafe.
And they have sparkly lattes according to Instagram.
Yeah.
We don't know.
They could be edited, but we're pretty sure they're actually sparkly. So that's why we picked this place. We tried to pick like unique latte places.
Yeah. Oh, it's like open.
Oh,
wait, I love that. I don't know what this is. We have to wait 30 minutes, so
we're gonna wait.
Yeah, we're gonna wait. Let's look at the menu.
The what is sparkly?
It's called the Bling Bling Honey Latte.
24 karat gold.
Did you just make that up?
No.
Oh.
Look how sparkly it is.
Tastes like coffee.
I'm not gonna lie. But it's actually, I mean, yeah, it just tastes like a latte.
Yeah, it tastes like a latte. I actually really like it.
Yeah. It's really pretty.
I like the taste of coffee. A lot of people don't.
A lot of people do. That's why they drink it. But okay.
But like our age, I feel like people don't like coffee.
Yeah.
But I actually like coffee.
No, it's pretty good. Aesthetically, it's very pretty.
I gotta say, look at that.
Just leaving L room. And I have a lot of interesting thoughts on my latte.
Yeah, all right. Okay. Aesthetic of the actual coffee itself
was beautiful. Awesome. It was sparkly.
I loved it.
It was gold. It was super cool. I don't know how they did it.
I'm gonna give it a plus five.
I've never
I think
seen
it was
a latte
so
that
cute.
Sparkles, so.
Yeah, it was really cute. Atmosphere vibe.
So when we first got there, the light up signs and everything was like super cool.
Yeah.
I loved everything. But then we had to wait 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And it ended up being like more than 30 minutes.
We were lucky because we made the conscious decision to go like walk around and go shopping a little bit more, and we got like ready Melville. But if we just decided to like wait there, it was kind of like
Yeah.
But then so as soon as we got there, all the tables filled up. So I feel like we were just there at like a bad time.
Yeah, definitely. I would give it like a plus three though. I like Cha Cha Matcha's better because it was cozy. Whereas that place
cozy.
Was more just cool, but not as like, you wouldn't want to sit down there with a
and
coffee
like
and do your work and chill.
Yeah, well, it'd be hard to do it at Cha Cha Matcha because it was loud. But yeah, I'll give it a plus
three for me.
Three, which is also what I gave Cha Cha Matcha. I think they're both like good in their own ways.
Yeah.
Taste.
Okay.
I liked this one more than Cha Cha Matcha.
See, I'm not like that big of a coffee like fanatic either way, but I did like
Let's
that.
Let's try to catch this light. Yeah.
I really liked the taste of the coffee. And it was just regular coffee it tasted. It didn't taste like anything different.
Yeah.
The honey sweetened it.
Yeah. I've started to become
Me too.
Really into coffee. Like I drink it every morning. And I really like it.
But I like matcha better, I think. I like the matcha better.
I liked this one more because I really like the coffee flavor with like the lightness and the sweetness with the milk. And
no,
it was kind of just
good.
Like a regular coffee though. So I'm gonna give it like a
I'm giving three. It a three.
Yeah. Price.
Okay.
Price. This was $7.50 worth
for
of
a latte. And I get it, the sparkles are what made it so expensive, but I think they
it's
could
just, like
just
edible glitter. It's
but I
like,
think that's how they're like making their money. Is like, it looks super cool, so let's just charge them as much as we want.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. So that was like really the only setback it has.
Trendy is the perfect word for it. It's just like you go there once, take a couple pictures.
Oh, look.
I think location is good.
Cause. We could go walk around while we had to wait, and there were plenty of shops. There was a Madewell, a Brandy.
Pretty funny.
Plenty of shops. I would give a location like a five.
I would give location plus five for sure.
Plus five.
See,
we're at Union Square.
Overall for L Room Cafe, I would give it a three. I'm kind of hard.
Okay, I would give it a three, and I'm giving Cha Cha Matcha a four.
Actually, yeah, I'll do that. I'll give Cha Cha Matcha a four and this one a three.
Ube latte with oat milk. Alright, I'm gonna try it. That's really good.
Really?
That's really good.
I'm so curious. I have no clue how it's.
That tastes like those buns we have at the
My favorite thing in the world.
Yeah. It's kind of weird. What is ube?
It's like purple
in a latte. It tastes the same, but yeah, it's pretty good.
So we just finished at Urban Backyard.
Yes.
It was the cutest place I've ever been to in my life.
Yeah, it was so like chill vibes, atmosphere, and aesthetic.
Atmosphere, it was so cute. It was so like zen and relaxing.
Yeah, there are flowers hanging from the ceiling.
Yeah, succulents. It was just that kind of like bohemian chill vibe. And it was so cute. And I give it a plus 5.
Yeah, plus 5
off
for
the charts.
Sure.
Like, I'll go back.
Yeah, definitely. Next time we're in the city, we were already talking about how we were going to go back. Yeah.
Aesthetic of the actual latte.
Plus five.
It was so cute. I liked it more than the sparkle one.
But it was purple, so it was super
cool.
Yeah,
so it was cute.
Price was a little expensive.
It was a little over $6.
Like a -1. Actually a 1.
The sparkly one was even more. What did we say for the sparkly?
Yeah, but the sparkly one was like sparkling.
But it was really
maybe
expensive.
Because it has ube.
It was like $7.50 for the sparkly. I give this one like a 1.
Yeah, maybe a 1 because that's not.
But like you get a lot out of it. Like there's a it's a big cup.
Cha Cha Matcha was probably best deal for your.
Yeah, bang for your buck. Yeah. Taste.
Okay, I didn't like the taste as much
Milly,
as Indi.
Milly,
because
we think doesn't like ube.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I don't like the ube dumplings either. That she.
That
loves.
I love. They're ube and lattes, and I love those little dumplings.
Yes.
Yeah, so but so this one I liked. I think it, actually, I would say it was my favorite, but I kind of like the sparkly one more.
Yeah, no, I might give it a 0 on taste because I could see how people would like it if they liked ube, but since I don't really like
it. I think I'll give it a 2. It's hard to drink that much of it.
Yeah, it's super
after,
strong.
After like a couple sips, like you're I feel like I'm done. Yeah. Overall, I would give the entire place like a 4 because they had so many other latte flavors too. Like it
like
wasn't just the one.
Yeah,
I would give it
was
a 4.
Really good. So and, our like, what's your favorite latte place of the day?
That one. Urban Backyard is my number one in my heart.
I think mine is Cha Cha Matcha.
Yeah, you really like
it. I like the vibe. I liked how it was all pink. I liked the matcha a lot. It was really tasty.
So 1 point for Urban Backyard and 1 point for Cha Cha Matcha.
Yeah. All right.
Not saying that the other one is bad.
Oh, no. Okay. All right.
Thank you guys for watching. So much for watching.
Hope you guys enjoyed this video.
Like and subscribe.
Let us know if you want us to do more One Bites and
excited. We love this One Bite series. Let us know what other additions you want to see from us. And we'll see you guys next time. All right, bye.
How do you turn it on? Okay, that.